Hello and welcome to the session. In this session, we will discuss about compound interest. The interest calculated not only on the initial principal but also on the accumulated interest of prior periods is called the compound interest. The compound interest arises when interest is added to the principal and this addition of interest to the principal is called compounding. If a man deposits certain amount, say T, in a savings account at a rate of interest R per annum, then suppose he would gain interest I on his deposit at the end of 1 year. Unless he takes out this interest I in cash, it will be added to the original amount P. So if he leaves his money in the account, then the next year interest will be charged on principal plus the interest, and this would continue for as long as the money is left in his account. And so this kind of interest is known as the compound interest. Now let us define the simple interest. Simple interest is the interest computed on the principal alone and we have a formula to find out the simple interest, say SI, and this is equal to P into R into T upon 100, where this P is the principal, R is the rate of interest, and T is the time in years. So, the basic difference between the simple interest and the compound interest is that simple interest is the interest which is computed on the principal alone and the compound interest is computed on principal plus the interest. Now, let us try to find out the compound interest for different cases. Consider the principal given by P as $6,000. Now, for the problems of type 1 in which the time T is in whole number of years we take the time t as 2 years the rate of interest say r be equal to 10% per annum now the principal p for the first year is taken as $6,000 time is 2 years and the rate of interest r is 10% per annum so the interest I for the first year would be equal to 6000 into 10 into 1 upon 100 dollars so this is equal to $600 now the amount A at the end of first year is equal to the principal P for the first year plus the interest I for the first year which is equal to 6600 dollars now the principal P for the second year would be equal to $6,600 rate would be 10% per annum time would be 2 years so now the interest I for the second year would be equal to 6600 into 1 into 10 upon 100 dollars and this is equal to $660 this is the interest for the second year the amount A at the end of the second year is equal to the principal for the second year plus the interest for the second year and that is equal to $7,260 now the compound interest after 2 years is equal to the amount at the end of the second year that is $7,260 minus the principal for the first year that is $6,000 and this is equal to $1,260 so this is the compound interest after 2 years this is how we calculate the compound interest when the time is given in whole number of years Now let's discuss type 2 in which the time t is not whole number of years. Suppose in this case the principal P is again given as $6,000 say the time t is equal to 2.5 years the rate of interest r is equal to 10% per annum as given in the previous case also now as the time is 2.5 years so we will find the interest for the first year for the second year and for the last half year Now the amount A at the end of the first year as calculated in the previous case is $6,600. So we write here $6,600 and the amount A at the end of the second year is calculated as $7,260. So we have $7,260. Now we will find the interest for the last half year, since the time is 2.5 years. So the principal P for the last half year would be the amount at the end of the second year, which is $7,260. Now here the time T is equal to half year, and the rate of interest R would be equal to the same, that is 10% per annum. Now in this case the interest for the last half year is equal to 7,260 into 1 upon 2 into 10, this whole upon $100. So here we have interest for the last half year is equal to $363. The amount A at the end of the half year is equal to the principal for the last half year plus the interest for the last half year, and this is equal to $7,623. Now the compound interest at the end of 2.5 years is equal to the amount at the end of the half year, which is $7,623 minus the initial principal that we had taken, which is $6,000, and so this would be equal to $1,623. So this is how we calculate the compound interest when the time is not in whole number of years. Now we discuss the type 3 problems in which the interest is different. For successive years, for the principal P, $6,000 time T as 2 years, and the rate of interest for successive years are 5% and 10%. So, for the first year, the interest would be equal to 6,000 into 1 into 5, this whole upon $100, and This is equal to $300. And the amount at the end of the first year is equal to the interest plus the principal, and so this is equal to $6,300. Now for the second year, the interest would be equal to the amount at the end of the first year would be taken as the principal for the second year. That is 6,300 into 1 into 10, this whole upon 100, and this is equal to $630. And the amount at the end of the first year is interest at the end of the second year plus the principal for the second year, which is $6,300, and so this is equal to $6,930. And in this case, the compound interest would be equal to the amount minus the initial principal, which was $6,000. So the amount at the end of the second year, which is $6,930 minus $6,000, is equal to $930. This is the compound interest. Now we have the type 4 problems where the interest is paid half yearly. In this case, we consider the principal P as $6,000, the time T as 1 year, and in this 1 year we have 2 half years. The rate of interest R is taken as 10% per annum, and this interest is paid half yearly. So we find the rate of interest half yearly is equal to half of 10%, and this is equal to 5%. Now let's find out the interest for the first half year. For this, the principal P is $6,000, time T is 1 half year, and the rate of interest R is equal to 5% per half year, and in this case the interest I would be equal to 6,000 into 1 into 5, this whole upon $100, and this is equal to $300. Now at the end of the first half year, the amount A is equal to $300, that is the interest plus the principal, which is equal to $6,300. Now we'll find out the interest for the second half year. For this, we take the principal P as $6,300 time T as 1 half year, and the rate of interest R is equal to 5% per half year. For this, the interest I is equal to 6300 into 1 into 5, this whole upon 100, and this is equal to $315. And the amount A at the end of the second year is equal to the interest plus the principal for the second year, and this is equal to $6,615. And in this case, the compound interest is equal to the amount minus the initial principal that we had taken, which is $6,000. So $6,615 minus $6,000 is equal to $615. So this is how we calculate the compound interest when the interest is paid half yearly. So we have discussed four types of problems to find out the compound interest. First, when the time is given in whole number of years. Second, when the time is not in whole number of years. Third, when the interest is different for successive years. And fourth, when the interest is paid half yearly. So this completes the session. Hope you have understood the concept of compound interest.